Hello everyone, let's keep going with more cases of indeterminate forms. We already covered 0 over 0, infinity over infinity, and 0 times infinity, which basically takes us to the two previous cases. In this video, let's cover the case infinity minus infinity. Again, reminding you, and I will be reminding this many times, we're not talking about infinity minus infinity as it is, that's why it's not 0. We're talking about the function f minus g. When one goes to infinity and another one goes to infinity, and the result is not obvious. If the first function increases to infinity faster than the second one, for example, it will be billions at some point minus 200 and so on, then the result will be plus infinity. If the second function grows faster to infinity, then the numbers for the first function are still small but growing. For the second, it becomes huge and negative, so it becomes negative infinity. If they grow at the same speed, the result is zero, and that's our job to understand what to do. Well, I will give you the list of suggestions how to fight these types of problems. Not physically, of course, but intellectually. So here are some interesting recommendations, or basically ideas. Let's call it ideas. Ideas how to deal with the cases when you have a limit as x approaches a or infinity, and then you have f of x minus g of x, and it becomes my infinity minus infinity case. So, what should we do? Step one, maybe if you see that you're working with trigonometric functions, try some kind of trig identities. Identities or even definitions. Maybe transforming tangent into sine and cosine will help. If you see several fractions, then try to create common denominator. And that might help. If you see some factoring might happen, so some parts are repeated and you can factor something, that might help. Also, we saw cases when you have square roots, then maybe it will help to multiply by the conjugate. Multiply by the conjugate. Do you remember what it means? A square root over square root with a different sign. And finally, maybe you're working with logs, and log minus log is log of the quotient. Then use laws of logs. Laws of logs. Basically, the idea is, again, to create a quotient. All of this should help you somehow. Maybe not all, but most of the time, we're trying to transform into a quotient. And now you tell me why we want to transform into a quotient. Do you understand why? Just because it sounds good? No, because quotients allow us to use L'Hopital's rule, right? So again, we're trying to go back to this first method where we learn how to use L'Hopital's rule. Okay, let's try. I'll give you a couple examples and see together if it's hard or not. Again, this is not the whole list. You can have different more cases, but that's the list of the common ideas. Example one. The first example has a limit as x approaches pi over 2 from the left. Uh-oh, if we see pi over 2, probably we're going to work with trigonometric functions. And indeed, it is a secant x minus tangent x. Doesn't sound bad though. Why do we have to even be bothered here? Let's check what is going on. Well, you see, secant at pi over 2 is infinity. And tangent at pi over 2 is infinity. Plus or minus, remember how they look like? Tangent, for example, is repeated infinitely many times. And so it has vertical asymptotes again and again and again, negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. So if we're approaching pi over 2 from the left, it goes to plus infinity. That's actually important if it goes to plus or minus, because if you have plus and if you have infinity plus infinity, that's still infinity. Big numbers plus big numbers, they give you big numbers. But big numbers minus big numbers, that's already not so trivial. So you have infinity minus infinity case. Okay, looking from this list, what do you think we should do? And I saw somewhere that we mentioned trig identities. Or definitions. I will do like this. Or definitions. In this case, I don't know any identity like secant minus tangent. What does it even mean? Do you know any identities at all? Maybe you forgot. Well, at least start with something you know. That's what I always say. So I will rewrite limit x approaches pi over 2 from the left. And I know what secant is. Secant is 1 over cosine. 1 over cosine x. Nice. I also know what tangent is. Tangent is sine x over cosine x. Now I have 1 over cosine minus sine over cosine. And now I have several fractions. Do you see something in the list? I see that if we're working with several fractions, I can try to create common denominator. And actually, it already has a common denominator, cosine. Then I will have limit as x approaches pi over 2 minus, basically from the left, cosine at the bottom, and 1 minus sine x at the top. And you see, we created a quotient just like we wanted. That's the whole idea. Let's see, maybe we don't need to use L'Hopital's rule here. Well, cosine of pi over 2 is actually 0. That's not very good. And sine of pi over 2 is actually 1. So 1 minus 1 becomes 0 as well. Fine, we have 0 over 0 case, and that allows us to use a L'Hopital's rule. That means I will differentiate the top and the bottom separately. Pi over 2. And I will have ratio of derivatives instead of the original functions. Derivative of 1 minus sine x is minus cosine x. Derivative of cosine is minus sine x. Well, minus cancels out minus, and we'll see what's gonna happen. Sine of pi over 2 is not 0 anymore, so the denominator actually is negative 1. Cosine of pi over 2 is still 0, so the answer is just 0. Not too bad. Example 2. Example 2 has logs in it. Do you guys like logs? Somehow I have very good feelings about logs every time because it has only three, four main properties you need to remember, and maybe a graph from time to time. And every time you see logs, it's not like we expect a lot of stuff from it. Usually, it's usually using those properties, laws of logs, or the graph. I also remember that it's very slow at infinity. So maybe sometimes we can use that. Okay, I see log minus log, and x goes to infinity. Well, 5 to the x at infinity is infinity. Then log at infinity, do you remember what it does? It grows slowly, but it goes to infinity at infinity. So the first guy definitely goes to infinity. And the right-hand side is the guy on the right is log of x, and at infinity it goes to infinity as well. And we don't know which one is faster. Kind of you can have intuition over here if be honest. Log of the just input or log of the exponential input, which one grows faster? So I assume the first log probably is crazy fast. So probably the first infinity you're gonna win, and the answer might be infinity. But let's see. Our goal is to create a quotient from this mass. We don't like having differences, infinity minus infinity. I'll put this in red. How to create quotient when we work with logs? Well, let's see. Laws of logs. That's one of the recommendations. So indeed, difference of logs gives me a quotient of logs. No, difference of logs is log of the quotient. So it's going to be 5x over x. And that's going to be input of the log. And all of this is inside of the limit. Let me put brackets to make it more visual. Now, properties of limits tells us that if the function is continuous, I can take this limit and push it inside of the log. And basically see first where the function inside of the logs go and make a conclusion out of that. Then it means I'm taking the natural log of the limit as x approaches infinity of 5 to the x over x. And all of this is inside of the log. So if this is going to be a finite number, I will have log of the finite number. If this is going to be infinity, it will be infinity. If it's zero, then, you know, ln at zero is not defined, but maybe we can claim it's negative infinity if it approaches zero from the right. Let's see what we have here. How to calculate this limit in blue? Several ideas. Either we see that this is infinity over infinity case, and we use L'Hopital rule separately. So I will have infinity over infinity case. So I will use L'Hopital's rule inside of this log. So I still have log, and then I will have limit x approaches infinity. 5 to the x prime becomes 5 to the x times natural log of 5. Remember, if exponential function doesn't have base e, you have to multiply by the log of the base. Derivative of x is 1. So what is the answer for this log? For this limit? When x approaches infinity, ln 5 is a constant, 1 is a constant, 5 to the x explodes to infinity. So the whole limit here is infinity, and the answer is infinity, because log and infinity is infinity, just like we expected at the beginning. Could you avoid using L'Hopital rule here? Well, in one of my videos, I actually explained what does it mean to compare speeds of functions at infinities. 5 to the x is much faster than x at infinity. Grows, let's say 5 of x grows faster, yes. Or is, right? But grows means going up. So I will say grows. No, let's do is. I kind of don't know which one is better. You decide. 5 to the x is faster than x at infinity, right? So I know that the numerator will be faster than the denominator. Since this is a competition, this is how I usually teach it, the function at the top will win, so the answer for the blue part over here will be infinity. And that's how you can avoid using L'Hopital's rule if you know speeds of functions. So check out the video called Speed of Functions, where I explain how to compare different functions. Log is the slowest one, linear function goes next, polynomials, exponential functions, factorials, and x to the x is the fastest one. Those two examples are actually good enough. You'll see more different cases, just look at the list I just gave you here, and hopefully you will find this list convenient and helpful, and follow it so to do your homework faster and not to freak out when you see infinity minus infinity cases. Thank you for watching.